हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ निकुल जायसवाल, लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग, श्री केजी पॉलिटेक्निक भरूच। वेलकम टू फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑफ आवर सब्जेक्ट कंप्यूटर एंड नेटवर्क सिक्योरिटी। सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर डिस्कसिंग टाइप्स ऑफ अटैक्स। सो इन द टाइप्स ऑफ अटैक वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस वेरियस वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ अटैक्स। So in the previous lecture, we have already discussed denial of service attack and distributed denial of service attack. So that attack basically attacks on availability parameter. So it will make the system or service unavailable to authorized users. Then we have discussed backdoors and trapdoors. So in the backdoors is a mechanism which will help us to enter into the system by bypassing the security mechanisms. So software developer intentionally create a backdoor to gain the system by bypassing authentication mechanism in certain circumstances. And next is sniffing. So sniffing is the process to capture the packets that are traveling in our network. So we can capture the packets that are traveling in our network, and we can identify useful information from that packet. Now in this particular lecture, we will discuss first spoofing, the next man in the middle attack, the next TCP/IP hacking, and at the last we will discuss phishing attack. So let's start with our first topic in this video lecture, that is spoofing. Now when the two machines or two users are communicating with each other, then the developer trust system between them. So when one machine receives any packet, it will see the identification of that machine. So how the particular user or particular machine will identify the another machine? So one method is through the IP address. So when one machine sends some information to second machine, it will be in the form of IP packets. So IP packet contain lots of information like source IP address and destination IP addresses. So from the source IP address, the second machine can identify that the packet has been come from the authentic user. So this is the basic mechanism in TCP/IP protocol. Now if attacker send some packet to a machine, target machine, with its own IP address, then target machine can easily identify that this packet is not come from any authentic user. So it can also identify that the packet has been come from any attacker. So what the attacker will do is, it will change its IP address in the IP packet. So when attacker send packet to a target system, first of all what it will do, it will modify the source IP address with the authentic user IP addresses. Clear? So a technique used to gain unauthorized access to computers, whereby the intruder or attacker, we can also say that it as an attacker, sends message to a computer with an IP address indicating that the message is coming from a trusted host. So what the attacker will do is, it will change the IP address in IP packet with the trusted host system's IP address. So first of all, the attacker need to identify the IP address of the trusted hosts. So attacker need to use some techniques to identify the IP address of the trusted hosts. So to engage in IP spoofing, a hacker must first use a variety of technique to find an IP address of a trusted host, and then modify the packet header so that it appears that the packet are coming from that host. So this is called as a IP spoofing. So in the IP spoofing, what the attacker will do is, it will modify the IP packet. Normally in the IP spoofing, the attacker will modify the source IP address in the IP header with the IP address of the trusted host. So this technique will be called as a spoofing. So in the spoofing, the target system will not be able to identify that that packet has been come from the attacker and not from the authentic user. So there are various levels of spoofing. The first is IP spoofing that we have discussed already. Then DNS spoofing, we can also spoof the domain name domain names in the IP packet headers. Then we can also use the ARP spoofing. Normally ARP and MAC spoofing will be used in the local areas, because in the local area only we are using ARP and MAC protocol. And we can also use the email spoofing. So in the email spoofing, what the attacker will do is, before sending an email to a authentic user, it will change the header and it will modify the email address in the header with the authentic user's email address or trusted system's email address. So this is all about the spoofing. Next attack is man in the middle attack. So as name implies, this attack generally occurs when attackers are able to place themselves in middle of two communicating parties. So what the attacker will do is, attacker will put himself in the middle of two communication parties. So as you can see in the figure, user and web application is communicating with each other with the TCP/IP connection. Now what the attacker will do, it will put himself in between the user and web application. So all the communication that has been done between the user and web application will go through the attacker only. So when the user sends some information to web application, that information come to the attacker, then attacker will forward that information to web application. And when the web application reply with some information, that information come to the attacker, and the attacker will again, that information will be sent to a user. So this is the basic working of man in the middle attack. Now in today's environment, the attacker will not be able to identify more information in the man in the middle attack, because all the communication between the different users or the different user and the service will be in the form of encrypted form. So in the man in the middle attack, now it is not possible to identify much informations. So this attack normally performed by using the session hijacking. So when user normally you, in the web application, we use the TCP/IP connection, and for the TCP we establish one connection and the session ID will be given to that connection. So what the attacker will do is, the attacker will hijack that session and it will put himself in between the user and web application. So a man in the middle attack is a type of cyber attack where a malicious actor, or we can also call it as an attacker, insert himself into a conversation between two parties, impersonate both parties and gain access to information that the two parties were trying to send to each other. So when the two parties are trying to send the information to each other, all the information will go through the attacker only. A man in the middle attack allows a malicious actor to intercept, send and receive data meant for someone else or not meant to be sent at all, without either outside party knowing until it is too late. So when the user and when the two users are communicating with each other, the attacker will intercept himself between the users, authentic users, and it will receive all the data that has been transmitting by the two users. Next attack is TCP/IP hijacking. So we already know that in the TCP, first of all, before transmitting any data, we establish the connection. So in the TCP, we normally use the three-way handshake mechanism to establish the connection between two parties. So when the connection is established, the session ID will be provided to that connection. So in the connection, first of all, let's suppose any user want to access the web services. So it will, the web server will ask for the username and password. Now the user will give the username and password and connection will be established. So when the connection will establish, session ID will be provided by the web server, and that session ID will be used as an authentication mechanism between the user and web server. So web server will identify all the information from that session as a authentic information. Now what the attacker will do is, so attacker will try to get the session ID between the user and the web server. So after getting the session ID from between the user and web server, it will send the information with that same session ID. So what the web server will identify? Web server will identify the information with the help of session ID. So web server will identify that the session ID is valid, so the information has come from the trusted party and not from the attacker. So this is the TCP/IP hacking will be done. So TCP/IP hacking is when an authorized user gain access to a genuine network connection of another user. So it is done in order to bypass the password authentication, which is normally the start of the session. So when the user and web server start the communication, it will use the username and password authentication. And after that authentication, they use the session to communication messages. So attacker will take the session, hijack that session, and that session will be used between the attacker and web server to get the informations. Next attack is phishing attack. So phishing attack is more like a social engineering attack to steal the information, useful information of the user. So in the phishing attack, what the attacker will do is, attacker will create one fake web page and it will send some message to you stating that your account has been deactivated by the system. So to reactivate that account, please log in to this particular web page. So this type of attack will be done in banking system and social media accounts. So phishing is a type of social engineering attack often used to steal in user data, including login credential and credit card numbers. So this is the example of phishing attack. So you can see that the link of the Facebook page is not correct. It is written as www.facebook.com. So what the attacker will do is, it will send a text message or an email with the link to a user stating that your account has been disabled by the system. So to reactivate the Facebook account, please log in here. That type of message will be sent to a user, and what the user will do, it will click on that link. Now normally the user will not read the link, it will just see the home page of the system. So from the home page, the user will think this is the actual Facebook login page, so it will enter the email login ID and password and it will try to log into that system. Now when you click on the login button, all the information, that is username and password, will be sent to a attacker. So this type of attack is called phishing attack. Same as in the banking environment, also phishing attack will be performed. So in that, the attacker will send that your bank account has been deactivated by the bank. So to reactivate the bank account, please click here, and the link will be provided. And when the user will click on the link, username and password will be prompt, and when the username and password will be sent entered by the user, and if the user click on the submit button, the user ID and password of the banking system will be sent to a attacker. So this is the phishing attack. So this is the end of our video lecture. I hope you did understand all the topics that we have discussed in this video lecture. After completing this video lecture, you need to appear for the quiz assignment and via Google Classroom. Thank you so much.